back to up front. The Democrats' win in the 10th Senate district sparked more talk of a blue wave in November, even a blue nami, as some called it on Twitter. Wisconsin Democrats would like to ride a wave to victory in November and deny Republican Governor Scott Walker a third term in office. The Democrats' field of candidates for governor is large, and as early campaign finance reports suggested last week, there is no clear frontrunner. We're talking about the race today with Mike McCabe, the former head of the Wisconsin Democracy Campaign, now a candidate for governor in Wisconsin. Mike McCabe, good to have you back on the program.
Thanks for having me.
So as somebody running for governor, what did the results from Tuesday night mean, or what do they foreshadow, in your opinion, for November?
There's tremendous hunger out there for a very different kind of leadership. There's frustration. There's a whole lot of people who are feeling forgotten and overlooked and written off, and they really want to see a shakeup.
You said especially in the northern part of the state, based on your experiences.
Our campaign has already traveled over 37,000 miles just since September 12th. The farther north we go, the more stirred up people seem to be.
And what specifically are they upset about and stirred up about?
I think a lot of times it's just people feeling like the folks in charge at the Capitol don't even know they're up there, aren't speaking to their concerns, aren't representing their interests, and they really feel forgotten. And there are too many forgotten people in forgotten places all over the state, and they're looking for representation, and I think they're also looking to throw a Molotov cocktail at the political establishment these days.
They did that already once, didn't they, with Donald Trump?
And I think we're going to see more. I think we're seeing people who have a tremendous hunger for a very different kind of leadership.
And when you talk to folks in northern Wisconsin, what's the message you're delivering right now? What seems to resonate with them?
I tell them that I'm from dairy farming country myself, and that people in every part of the state.
Originally, but you spent a lot of time in Madison.
Well, I've lived an urban existence. I've lived a rural existence. I've lived both, and people deserve representation. And what we've got is a government right now that is working really, really well for a wealthy and privileged and well-connected few. But an awful lot of people are being left behind and ignored, and people deserve representation. They deserve to have their concerns addressed. And we got small towns out there that are digging up pavement and putting down gravel because they can't afford to keep filling their potholes. They can't get access to high-speed internet. They feel really cut off. How do you live in a 21st century economy or even fully participate in modern American life without those kinds of things? And those needs are being ignored, and they want to be noticed.
Your campaign last week announced something called a clean government agenda. Just give us a sample of what you're talking about that you think is something the people of Wisconsin want.
Well, we obviously got to rein in big money, and as a candidate for governor, you can take a $20,000 check from an individual. I consider those to be legal bribes. I won't take them. I'm not taking any single donation over $200.
Although you can give that up to $1,000, 205 times.
Supporters can give more than one time, but no more than a total of $1,000, which is 5% of the legal limit, because I consider those huge donations to be legal bribes. And then once elected, government officials, if they take actions that reward those donors, that should be prohibited. So I would change our conflict of interest laws to say that if you've gotten over $1,000 from a supporter, you can't take an action that would benefit them. You have to withdraw from that decision. You have to recuse yourself. And so it's redistricting reform. It's getting back good ethics enforcement laws. It's like six different ways that we can address cronyism and corruption and what I consider the equivalent of legal bribery in our political system today.
Do you think Foxconn is cronyism? The Foxconn deal?
Well, it's also just a horribly flawed strategy for building a sturdy economy. You can't build a sturdy economy with corporate welfare. We've got to take our resources and build that sturdy economy from the bottom up. We've got to empower 5.5 million people in this state to do more for themselves and their families and for each other. Trying to shower tax breaks and state subsidies on a few or one global conglomerate from Taiwan and hope that they work magic for the rest of us is just not going to do the trick. It's an enormous cost for our state. The benefit is not going to meet that cost. But it's just a flawed strategy for trying to build a sturdy economy.
You mentioned earlier the way you're running your campaign, taking small donations. The latest financial reports came in. You've raised $104,000, about $25,000 of that from you and your wife. There are a lot of candidates out there. Can you run a viable campaign when many people still don't know who Mike McCabe is? Mm-hmm. Can you run a viable candidacy
on such a limited amount of money? How do you get yourself known in a race with so many candidates?
This campaign has got to be a 21st century equivalent of the way Bill Proxmire won elections in the state for 30 years, that's what we're committed to. That campaign finance report doesn't reflect the true strength of our campaign, and that's the volunteer army that is being assembled, and all the travel. I mentioned traveling 37,000 miles in the state and building a truly grassroots campaign. And we're going to have some money, but there's no candidate in the field who raised even a tenth of what Scott Walker raised. There's no candidate in this field who has even a tenth of the cash on hand that he has. So Scott Walker won't be beat with money. He's got to be beaten with people power. He's got to be beaten with a truly grassroots campaign. And he's got to be beaten with imagination. It's up to us to describe to the people of Wisconsin what this state has the potential to become and how we reach that potential.
Mike McCabe is one of the many Democratic candidates for governor. We appreciate you being on the program.
Thank you, Mike.
Thanks very much.